Hello, everybody. I'm Tony Hlavik, a docent aboard Midway. I'm also have very long experience working on this airframe. This airframe is E2. E2 has been in service for over 54 years. It's the longest serving aircraft aboard aircraft carrier. Its prime purpose is airborne early warning and interceptor control. We have a 5-person crew, and I say 5 persons because we also have females that fly these airplanes. In fact, recently we had an all-female crew that flew the E2 on a mission. The 5 people in this airplane all have separate jobs. The 2 persons up front are aviators. They fly the airplane. Back here in the back end, we call it the back end, 3 people are back here. The person sitting in this seat that I'm sitting in right now is called a CICO, Combat Information Center Officer. He's the overall mission commander. Usually he's a senior lieutenant, a lieutenant commander, or maybe even a commander. The person to his right, the first seat, is the RO, radar operator. He's responsible for making sure all the mission equipment is working right. The guy to my left, the very aft seat, is the ACO, Air Control Officer. His prime job is to communicate with the aircraft in the battle group to make sure they get the instructions that we need to send to them. What our prime job is to collect data, transmit that data back to the Combat Information Center aboard the aircraft carrier, and act on that data. We do that through voice, and we do it through data. The crypto equipment that we have aboard the airplane provide us a crypto voice and crypto data. We have 10 radios on this aircraft that are used for not only voice, but for data. The symbology you see on the scope represents what we're going to send back to this Combat Information Center aboard the ship. Shape of the symbol defines what it is. If it's round, it's a good guy. If it's square, it's an unknown. If it's triangular, it's a hostile. E2 flies is the first fixed-wing aircraft off the aircraft carrier deck. It'll fly about 200 miles away from the battle group, 25 to 30,000 feet up. From that vantage point, it can see 600 miles across. All the data it collects, it digitizes, encrypts, sends on a digital message back to the aircraft carrier to be further acted upon. We also receive data from the aircraft carrier and from other ships in the battle group. All that data is also encrypted and decrypted once it gets in the airplane. We communicate with the ship, we communicate with the airplanes through an encrypted source. We call that a covered radio. Let's say we want to assign these fighters to intercept these bogeys here, or bandits. We'll send a message to them, both heading, distance on where to go, and steering commands to them. So again, the way we do it is through crypto. We have voice crypto, data crypto, and another system called IFF that you may have been exposed to. IFF, identify friend or foe. It's a prime system aboard the airplane to identify the bad guy, the bandits. All airplanes have to have an IFF system aboard to fly in controlled airspace. They transpond to what's called Mode 3 C code. Military aircraft all transpond to what's called a Mode 4 encrypted code. Every day we put a new code in that system. In fact, we put 2 codes in it in case the day changes. It's so important, that crypto that we put in that Mode 4 system, that every time an airplane leaves the flight deck, there's a kid out there checking it to make sure it works. He's got a little handheld gun that interrogates the airplane. If the airplane doesn't transpond back to his Mode 4 interrogation, he'll down the airplane. That's how important it is. And this is why it's important. If we're in a combat area and the rules of engagement allow it, and we see these unknowns here, and we interrogate them on Mode 4, and they don't respond back, we know they're bad guys. So we classify them as bad guys, and then we send that intercept in order to send a kill order, a weapons-free order, we call it, in order to interdict them. If you have a chance, come to the flight deck, walk around the E2, perhaps you'll even get to go inside. Thank you very much for coming aboard.